grab that right there. Are you ready?
Oh.
Is you ready?
Ready.
You say you ready.
Oh.
Whole squad ready.
Ready.
Is you ready?
Huh?
Are you ready?
Ready.
Is you ready? Whole squad ready.
We came here to see Jet. What you got?
Oh.
No, no, no.
Not on my watch.
No way.
So why Green Bay? I'm assuming you had other options.
Yeah, man. I had a few to choose from, but I mean, ultimately it came down to, you know, what I seen and what I felt like I believed in this team. You know, the history of this organization and feeling like I'm, you know, wanted by an organization. That's really what it came down to.
What did you see in Green Bay?
Yeah, obviously, you know, young quarterback, young skill guys, good offensive line. I mean, so for a running back, you know, can't load the box. You know, and when you do, you still got guys that can move people around. I think that's the thing that kind of excited me the most.
You got to see this team and that young quarterback up close early last season.
Yeah.
What were your impressions then, and how much did having a quarterback to join the offense with kind of play a factor?
Yeah, really, I was telling people, man, we were scouting from when we was playing them last year. I seen them make some throws. I'm like, yeah, a lot of people can't do it. I like running backwards on one foot and slinging it on a dime. That kind of got me excited when I just started thinking about him, like from watching film on him. And just to see the way he throws the ball effortlessly and the like grit he plays with, you know, I'm very excited to play with him.
You know, the Raiders have been one of those teams that just haven't been able to fill that position consistently. What does that do to you to have a guy like Jordan in this offense that is a franchise guy like that?
Yeah, to have a guy so young and, you know, playing as well as he has, and, you know, a guy that's going to be around, you know, for a long time. It's fun, you know, to be able to have something stable and know what you're going to get out of a guy week in and week out. So that's very exciting for me.
Sorry.
Are you good?
Your first 4 years, you did 3,000 yards. We all know what you did in 2022. What do you point the finger at, or how do you explain what happened last year? Just the numbers.
Yeah. Yeah, you know, honestly, as a team, you know, with the contract stuff and all of that coming in, it was a little different. We had a lot of new moving parts. We didn't really know who the quarterback was going to be. We didn't really know, like, what our identity was going to be. So, you know, the first few games was kind of rough. And then, you know, we started to kind of figure it out a little bit, but we couldn't really stay consistent. And then, you know, towards the end of the year, I ended up having an injury. So, it was just one of them situations where it's like you expected a lot out of that season, and it just didn't go that way.
Everybody says, sorry, Chris, go ahead. I'm sorry. Everybody says you're built for cold weather. You can power and speed and all that.
Yeah.
Do you like playing in cold weather? Is it a lot of it?
Oh, as a running back, yeah. You love playing in the cold because people don't want to hit you. You know what I'm saying? And then after a while, you know, you start to wear on them and, like, it just makes it a lot easier. You know, I think if I was defensive, I might be like, but as a running back, I love it.
When you and Xavier were at school together, did you ever think maybe you would play together in the NFL?
Nah, man, never. Like, never. You know, obviously, you know, you think that it's a possibility. But, you know, just with him, like me knowing him for so long, and even like over the years, we still talk all the time, you know. So for me to be able to come here with him, we was talking about it last night. We were sitting down eating. I was like, man, it's special. And I don't think it's really hit me yet, you know, about being here and everything like that, but I think it's going to be fun.
Obviously, he's a great player. What kind of guy is he? You obviously know him better than anybody else around here.
Yeah, I mean, he's a real good dude, man. I mean, his mom, his dad, they're just good people. He come from a good home. He's one of them guys that he's going to take care of, you know, his teammates and stuff outside of the building, you know, the things that people don't really notice or look at. For him to be as young as he is, he's definitely a leader.
Josh, what's your relationship with Rich Bisaccia?
Yeah. Man, Coach Bisaccia, he was, I'm not going to lie, he was one of the main reasons that I was kind of like wanting to come here too. Just knowing that he was already here and just dealing with him in the past, man, we've always had a tight relationship. You know, that year where he was head coach, we had a lot of like real conversations. We sat down, we talked about life and everything. So to be able to, be around him and that energy that he has every day, I think it's going to be fun.
Yeah, favorite stories with Xavier? Xavier going back to the Bama days, I imagine you guys squared off in practice a few times.
Yeah, man, I remember his first, what is that, like spring, during spring ball, his first spring ball. You know, he was kind of quiet at first. He was one of them guys that like you would just see him work. And then I actually seen him step into that, like that leader role and everything, you know, being a guy and like starting to like demand more out of the players and things like that. But my first thought of him honestly was like, I like the way that this dude came in. I like people that, you know, they come in and put their head down and work and improve it, you know, and he was one of them guys. So he definitely had my respect.
Josh, where else, I know Sucker was fast in free agency, but what were your other options?
Man, it was probably like 10 or 12 teams. It was like 10 or 12 teams. And it was kind of weird because they all was hitting me at once, and it was like a small window, you know. So I'm like, man, like you trying to weigh your options and, you know, figure it all out. But ultimately, like I said, man, I just liked what they had going on over here, you know, going to the playoffs and actually competing for the Super Bowl and things like that. It's something that I always, you know, wanted to be a part of. And I told them that playoff ball is a little different, and I really haven't experienced it. So that was definitely something that I want to, you know, leave my mark on.
You mentioned young skill position players. You're the oldest one.
Yeah.
Is that a little bit of a different view?
Yeah. Yeah, it's weird because I'm like, man, I ain't that old. Yeah, but I think that's dope, though, because obviously, you know, last year a lot of them young guys in the beginning of the season was still trying to figure it out. I mean, at least that's what it looked like from the outside looking in. You know, when it started to click, because for most young guys, it's just about experience. So them having that whole year's worth of experience and then coming in this year, I'm excited to see a lot of them take that step. So I just hope to be, you know, a part of that and hopefully help in any way I can.
Joining a young offense, you're essentially replacing a guy in 33 who's pretty loved around here.
Yeah.
What kind of shoes do you feel like you're stepping into, not just on the field, but from a leadership role too, with so much young guys around?
Yeah, I actually know Aaron, you know, so I already know what kind of guy he is, you know what I'm saying? A great dude, man. And obviously he's a legend around here just from what he's done in his time that he's been here. You know, I don't really consider myself coming in and, you know, like replacing what he's done. I just try to hold that standard.
How do you know him?
Yeah, I mean, we used to be out in Miami train, Bomberitos and stuff like that. So yeah, I've been around him like in the off season a few years, so yeah.
Do you know AJ Dillon at all?
Not as much. Yeah, not as much. We contacted last night for the first time, but yeah, that's, I look forward to meeting them too.
Josh, you won the captain's patch, you know, in your career. So how do you kind of balance, you know, wanting to, you know, maybe still be a leader in that way, but yet you're coming into like a brand new, whole new situation?
Yeah. To me, it's easy, man. You just come in and earn the guy's respect. And you do that by, you know, going to work, putting in the work in. You know, once you earn the guys' respect and they see the way you, you know, go about business on a day-to-day basis, that's kind of how you step into that role. It's not really something that you kind of ask for. It's just kind of something that's shown.
Josh, based on what you've seen from the offense, you mentioned you watched it, you know what Jordan is all about. Where do you think you fit? Because you're a three-down back, you've caught a ton of passes in your career. How do you fit into this offense?
Yeah, man. I mean, I was talking to Coach about that actually yesterday. And I was telling him, man, I feel like I want to catch it a little more. I feel like, you know, I didn't get to show that as much as I would like. So that's definitely something, the conversations that we had. I know, like, you know, the schemes out here, they kind of do a lot of, you know, outside zone running. So I think it just fits me, man. I can't wait to get in and, you know, kind of fill it out and see where I fit in. But also, you know, try to leave my mark on it, too.
In your mind, what do you do to make sure you're here long-term? You're the oldest guy on the offense, but you can be here long-term. Mm-hmm. Contracts tend to change, even though they're written for a certain duration. What do you need to do to be here long-term?
Like I said, man, I think the best thing to do is come in and just put your head down and work. You know, be a leader in the locker room with the guys, and, you know, be a leader in the community. I think that all of them things are important. So I think that's the best start on the way to that track.
No, he wasn't drafted, but you and Keyshawn were same class.
Yeah.
It's kind of cool to see he's made two All-Pro teams since mm-hmm. he's come here. Have you talked to him?
Yeah, man, we've talked a lot. We talked a lot. Like I said, he's one of the guys I always keep up with him, too. Coming in, you know, Keyshawn is very charismatic guy. But, man, we was talking last night and just about, you know, this place. And he told me how much it reminded him of college ball and how much he's just – a real genuine love for football and what you do on a day-to-day basis. And, you know, he kind of sold me. Like, I'm like, yeah, he kind of got me, like, ready to play. But, man, good dude, man. He's back today, so I don't know if y'all going to talk to him or not. But, yeah, this is a real good dude.
What have your impressions been of Matt LaFleur and the early conversations as well with him?
Yeah, I honestly didn't think he was going to be as cool as he is. I don't know. You know, head coaches are sometimes a little, you know, but – man, he's been cool so far. And, you know, we've already been talking ball and schemes and you know, systems and all that. I got the iPad yesterday. I kind of looked over it a little bit. I think he's going to be fun to play for, man. I think that whenever you have a young coach like that and, you know, the guys that's, like, energetic and things like that, they kind of make it more fun to play for. And so I'm looking forward to that.
Josh, has there been any thought into your number? Are you going to keep eight?
It's still in the works. Everybody keep asking me. So I kind of really don't know. I got to really see what's available. You know, if I can get eight, you know, I'll make it worth it for them. You know what I'm saying? If it's possible, you know, but if not, you man, I'm good either way. Yeah.
You broke a lot of tackles, especially in 2022. Not every guy has that ability. What is the secret to that?
I think contact balance, man. You know, understanding angles, understanding how the body moves, you know, stuff like that. Like, if I'm coming at an angle, I look at the way guys' shoulders and, you know, their momentum is taking them, and I kind of try to use it against them. I look at football kind of like chess, especially because the defenders got to react to me because I'm an offensive player. And so, you know, I just kind of try to play mind games, whether I might run you over one play or make you miss the next. That's kind of like what I get into.
You carry the football a lot in 5 years in a league that doesn't have a lot of workhorse guys. You're one of the few. How do you keep your body fresh and manage that workload?
Man, you got to take care of yourself. That was the biggest adjustment, I would say, coming in from college to the pros, is learning how to take care of yourself. You know, I kind of had the opportunity to really, like, you know, speak with, like, Tom Brady and all of these kind of guys that kind of guided me along with that, whether it's, you know, nutrition or, you know, getting your body worked on certain things, you know, as quickly as possible to be able to stay as fresh as possible. And, you know, obviously playing a running back, that's a hard thing to do, you know, and it's a constant job, and it's something that you got to be very, like, meticulous with. So for me, it's been interesting, but man, hopefully I can figure it out here, get everything, you know, acclimated with the people and that's out here that do, you know, the body work and things like that.
What's the biggest thing you learned from Tom in those conversations?
Man, so my first thing that I learned from him, man, was the guy's really cool. You know, I didn't think he was gonna be, like, you know, that cool. And he surprised me because my very first conversation with him, he knew my name and everything. And I'm like, dang, Tom Brady know who I am. But he just tell you, man, like, he's a real dude. He tells you, like, what you need to expect him, and, you know, the type of mentality that you need to have. And even with off the field stuff, man, he's an open book. And it's rare to find a lot of guys that's like that, especially, you know, that's accomplished as much as he has in this league. So I'm definitely grateful for that.
What do you think about the way the NFL values running backs? Do you think it's better now than it was, or how do you assess it?
I think that everything comes full circle. It's in, you know, in the cycle. So, you know, right now it might be a little rough, but I think that, you know, everything changes. You kind of see what's going on with running backs, going on with safeties right now. And like I said, I just think there's something that it just got to take its course. Obviously, you know, you can help yourself out by playing good and, you know, make yourself more available, and the more you can do, you know, the better position to be. But yeah, I just think it's one of them things.
So why Green Bay? I'm sure you had a lot of teams that were one of the best safety in free agency. So why did you choose these guys?
Obviously, great organization, great franchise, a lot of history here, a lot of winning. It's something that, you know, I've always, you know, wanted to do. Something that, you know, I've done a lot of time while I've been playing football. And you know, just the atmosphere is great. Obviously, this is my first time being here, so. It takes me back to, like, my Bama days. So that's a feeling that obviously that I love. So So far, I love it, and it's going to be fun.
Did you and Josh in college ever think maybe in the NFL you would play together?
Nah, never, never. I'm glad that we back on the same team, though. I can tell you that, because he's a special back, somebody that really good friends with. You know, he's a great teammate. He's a guy that plays really hard, makes a lot of plays. So it's going to be fun to just be back on the field with him and practicing against him.
If it was something you never thought of, I'm assuming you certainly never thought it would be in Green Bay.
Yeah, nah, you never know what could happen. But, yeah, like I said, I'm just glad we're back on the same squad and, you know, back having that common goal and being on the same team doing it.
Do you have a favorite story about Josh from your Bama days?
Ooh, I don't. You know, we had a lot of good moments, you know, back at Bama. So it's too many to kind of just pinpoint one. But we, like I said, we had a lot of fun there. So plan on doing the same thing here. So
did you have any contact with Derek and sort of this free agency process, Coach Ainsley and your previous connection to him? Was that any influence for you at all?
Not really. I didn't even know that he was here until I did the interview with Kay, and you know, she mentioned it, and then that's when I figured out that he was even here. So I had no clue that he was even here. Last time I knew that he was at the Chargers, but I didn't even know he was over here. So once I heard that, obviously, you know, it was something that I was happy about, and it definitely was something that you know, sparked interest for me big time. So
you beat these guys last year, but what stood out about maybe this offense, this team, when you were studying them leading up to that?
Explosive, fast, able to score points, have a really good quarterback, and young, talented group of guys. So just seeing how they play, and obviously playing them a couple times, you know, before in the past, has always been pretty competitive games and pretty tough games to play. It's pretty, it's fun to watch. It's going to be fun to be a part of it and, you know, see it.
I don't know if you've been able to talk to that really good quarterback yet, but would you want to let him know about the fumble?
I talked with him. He actually reached out to me once, you know, everything was kind of done, and just congratulated me and welcomed me to the team. Everybody's been pretty welcoming, so it's been a great feeling just to be here. When I first got to the airport, like, people were already like knowing, you know, how I was and just wanted to take pictures. So just been super friendly and super welcoming, and it's been a joy for me and my family, and I can't wait to experience more of it.
You know, I asked Josh the same question, but in this league, having a quarterback means everything, right?
Yeah.
You have a chance to contend with a quarterback. Yep. How much did Jordan and that allure of having a quarterback kind of play a factor in your decision?
A big factor. Obviously, this is a competitive league, and you need an elite quarterback, you know, to be able to even have a chance. And I believe that, you know, he is an elite quarterback. Obviously, I played against him and I've watched him play. And I think he's really good, and the sky's the limit for him. And, you know, I know he's a great leader. I've heard great things about him. So it's going to be real fun just being a part of, you know, this team and, you know, being able to go to work with these guys every day. It's going to be a hungry group, I can already tell. We got a lot of young talent, and it's just going to be fun.
So we spoke with Jeff Hafley. Mm-hmm. After he was hired. He was asked about what he likes to see in the safety position, and he went on, and then he said, it sounds like I'm describing the perfect player.
Yeah.
Are you that perfect player? How do you think you fit his system?
Well, I don't think any player is perfect, but I will tell you that I'm striving for that. You know, every day I go out and practice, it's going to be you know, everything that I got 100%, and same way for the game. So we actually had dinner last night, and we talked for a little minute. So seemed like a great guy, and I know we're going to have a lot of fun together for sure. We kind of talked about some things yesterday, just as far as play-wise. But I'm just looking forward to being part of, you know the defense and seeing where I can, you know, help and you know, try to make plays and help us to be successful and win.
We'll see you all over the place?
That's the plan. That's the plan. Yeah, that's the plan. So I cannot wait. You know, that's something that I've always wanted to do, just be able to play everywhere and you know, do different things throughout the game. So I know I'm going to be able to do that, you know, being here.
For Packers fans who might not have seen you play, what do you bring on the field?
Heart, competitiveness, and just playmaking ability. Instincts are really high. And, you know, just making the guys around me a lot better and pushing them and, you know, just trying to put on a show, really. That's my goal, is to go out there and play as best as I can and, you know, be able to, you know, help the team and put the team in best position to be able to win games. So, you know, that's why I'm here and, you know, that's what I'm going to be here to do.
You mentioned kind of a leadership style there. Does that just evolve? I mean, your position kind of is a leadership position.
For sure. I think, you know, ever since high school days and even before, like, I've always kind of been, you know, in that position to lead, you know, vocally and with my play. So I think just being here is going to elevate it a lot more, having, you know, the guys and the talent around me to be able to help me and improve. But the leadership is still going to be the same. It's going to be better than what it has already been in the past. And I'm just trying to continue to just keep growing and keep, you know, being a better player, a better teammate. And, you know, that's really what the goal is for me.
For a guy that can do everything, I mean, you can be deep, you can be in the slot, you can be in the box. Is there one that you enjoy the most? Like, is there one that you...
It depends on the game. Like, for me, I'm more so like, whatever we need for that game, I want to go do. So, like, I try not to get too, like, focused on one spot. I never, like, try to box myself in. And I think that's what, you know, gives me the ability to be able to play in different spots in the defense and in any scheme and be able to do it at a high level. So that's kind of how I've always been. And you know, it's just, like I said, it's going to continue to improve. And I'm going to continue to learn more and you know, be better in different spots. And I know the coaches are going to, you know, help me to get to where I want to be.
When you think about the last week and a half, the Giants could have tagged you. They didn't. Were you surprised by that? Were you thinking even after that you're going to end up still in New York? What has kind of gone through your mind through this process?
Yeah, I wasn't really sure what they were going to do. I know we have a great relationship with, you know, the organization, with all the staff over there, with Joe, with Dave's, with Mr. Mayor. So I wasn't really sure what they were going to do. But, you know, it played out, and I couldn't really, you know, tell you, you know, what was going to happen when I was going through it. I was going through so many emotions. I didn't really know what was going to happen. I didn't know where I was going to end up being. I just want to say shout out to, you know, the New York Giants, just for the 4 years that we had, you know, where they were special. Obviously went through a lot of ups and downs, but, you know, it's a team and an organization that, you know, is forever, you know, going to be in my heart. So, you know, all love to them, and I'm just glad to be here.
You racked up a boatload of tackles, 104 tackles last year, and some of the stats were just that you only missed like maybe 6 or 7 all season. So what makes a good tackler, and how did you become such a good one?
I think it's just how I prepare. You know, I practice hard. When you practice hard, you usually play pretty hard. So I try to I critique myself like a whole bunch. I try to just get better at the small things. I try to perfect my craft, and that's always, you know, how I've been. And you know, obviously, like, I don't go into it like, oh, I'm not trying to miss a certain amount of tackles. I just kind of go out there and play and see where the ball lands. So that's kind of just how it is. And I try to improve, you know, that I'm going to try to improve that number from what it was last year, because I think even that 6 or 7 is too much for safety. So we're going to get that number down for sure.
So you joined a team that's got high expectations. They really had no safeties. You're getting a lot of money. It would seem like a lot of pressure and expectations on you. How do you handle all that?
I don't think it's pressure. You know, like I said, I'm here to perfect my craft, so I don't really feel any pressure ever. I just try to go out there and play my best and compete. And like I said, I'm trying to win at the end of the day. So, and I know what that takes to be able to win games and you know, win championships. So I don't ever really feel pressure. I know that, you know, a lot of these guys in here are super motivated and that are hungry, and I'm the same way. So it's going to be fun. It's going to be a fun time.
Coach Saban is known for developing defensive backs. What was it like to play for him, and how do you help your game grow the most?
Yeah, it was super fun. He helped me in ways that I can't even explain. You know, just the discipline part of it. You know, that perfecting craft, you know, of what I talk about, I got that from him. Just seeing how he handled his business every day, how he came into meetings, how he went about practice. I learned a lot from him, and it stuck with me, you know, throughout my career. And he's definitely made me, you know, want to be a lot better than what I am, you know, today. And never thinking, you know, I'm just being complacent. I never get complacent. I try to keep improving. I always know that there's, you know, ways to improve my game. And, you know, that's just something that, you know, he's always taught me and stuck with me since then.
Hey, everybody. If my math is correct, it's two guys with three things. And, Mike, you are up.
Well, a couple of things that we heard from Josh Jacobs and Xavier McKinney the first time we got to chat with them that they are very excited about. One, they are former Alabama teammates, and they are now reunited in the NFL with the Green Bay Packers. And the other thing is both of these guys are really excited to play with an up-and-coming team with a franchise quarterback now in Jordan Love, and they are looking forward to being on a contender. Both of these guys, they've been to the playoffs only once in their careers each so far, and they're looking forward to some potentially long playoff runs maybe with the Green Bay Packers.
First impressions from my side is what's not to like. First of all, these guys are difference makers. You can tell by their tape. You can tell by the numbers they've put up and their time in the league. They are difference makers. They will make a difference in Green Bay. Another thing, they look the part. Josh Jacobs is 5'10", around 220. There is some substance to the dude. I imagine when he hits you, you feel it. And as a matter of fact, his tape says as much. Xavier McKinney, they list him at 6 feet, 200 pounds, roughly, 201 actually. And he is the longest 6 feet, 200 pounder I have ever seen. Did you think he was 6 feet?
Yeah.
I thought he was 6'2", 6'3", that kind of thing.
Absolutely.
He's got length. I mean, he just looks different than what it says on the program. Mm-hmm. So that's something to watch. The other thing is that these guys are both, as you mentioned, from Alabama. I love that pedigree. Nick Saban puts up with no baloney. He works those guys, and these guys have come to Green Bay ready to work. You can tell by their demeanor, you can tell by the way they talk. And the other thing that probably overrides all the other stuff is that both these guys were captains on their respective teams last year. When your best players, and these guys will be among the Packers' best players, when your best players are your best people, you're in a great, great situation locker room wise. Mike, do you have anything else?
One last thing I'll say about Xavier McKinney. I asked him about his tackling because he racked up 116 tackles for the Giants last year, and the stat service has had him.
But you mentioned his missed tackles.
Yeah, well, I wanted to ask him about that. The stat service has had him for, you know, six or seven. Six or seven missed tackles, right, which is a really, really low number when you're putting up 100-plus over the course of a season. And his answer to that question, six or seven's too many. I'm going to get that number down. Well, when you're already one of the best tacklers in the league and your attitude is that you're still going to work to improve, that's a good guy to have on your defense.
You are right. Bottom line, a couple of good guys are joining the Green Bay Packers. And that's two guys with three things. See you next time.
Bring what you got. I'm going to the top. I'm going to the top. Are you ready? Is you ready? You say you